Okay, today I'm showing you how to power bleed a car, the brakes for a car. I show this on my 2013 Jeep Grand Cherokee, but it's very similar to other cars too. I have this power bleeder here, and the first thing we need to do is we need to jack up the car. I use four jack stands from Harbor Freight. Two of those are on recall. You have to take them back because they collapse on themselves. That's important to know when you own those from Harbor Freight. So either use something better than that, or you pay attention to when they collapse that you jump out underneath quick. We need to remove all the caps from the bleeder nipples, all four from all four wheels, and keep them in a safe spot because we want to reuse them later and put them back on. Very important to not get dirt on those bleeders. The brake fluid we catch in a catch bottle here with, look at my patented bottle, with a rubber hose connected to it here. And then we think about of keeping everything super clean. So we do not want to contaminate the new brake fluid with anything, okay? We have to pump this thing up to fill up tank. Right, so this one has 1.5 liters of new brake fluid in it. And when we do this kind of thing and put stuff under pressure, it is advisable to wear safety glasses and also gloves too if you get in contact with the brake fluid. I try to be very clean here, so I don't spill anything. I don't wear gloves in this case. We don't want to have more than 20 psi on here. In my case, the master cylinder was removed, and I'm going to open those brake lines here to release the air in case there is some in the master cylinder. On this Jeep here, it's a 14 millimeter wrench. Everything on this car is metric. And I let the fluid drip out a little bit, get rid of the air in case there is any in there. I am not wasting too much fluid here. There's others that use enormous amounts of brake fluid to flush the system and do this. Mine system is very clean. I don't use so much fluid here. Just get the air out. If it didn't work for the first time, you just do it again. Okay, so then we clean this up and we go to the wheels. We start with the bleeder that is the furthest away from the master cylinder. In this case, it's rear right. And we look for the stream in the bottle here to come out there with no bubbles and no interrupts. Like a solid, steady stream is an indicator for no air in the system. Then I go to the rear left, front right, front left. The rules are the same. We want a steady stream and no bubbles and drops and drips and whatnot. This has to come out steady. Okay, I know I have 1.5 liter in the power bleeder up front, so that's how much I can get out of the wheels. This little bottle here is a quarter of what I have up front. So I know after four of those bottles, I would suck new air back in here, so I have to refill the power bleeder. All right, so when you're done with the system, this is the front left here. Then we need to release the pressure from the power bleeder before we remove the cap from the reservoir. So if we would take this off, it would spray us in our face. That's why we wear safety glasses. So I'm releasing the pressure. Slowly, if you can. There's just air in this bottle at that point up here on the bottle, so there will be no fluid spraying out. There, zero. And then we can remove it from the master cylinder here from the master reservoir. Last thing we need to do is to adjust the level to the maximum. I, in this case, have to remove fluid. You may have to refill or fill in more. So we want to be at the maximum level. And when we're done, we need to close the reservoir cap. There we go. See that everything is clean down there. The fluid in a once opened container will not last longer than 2 years, the same as the one in the vehicle. We then seal all the bleeder nipples with the rubber caps on all four, and then we put the wheels back on. Your bleeder tool, if you want to clean that, never ever clean the stuff with water. That's very bad, because the brake fluid is hygroscopic, means it attracts water, that's bad for it. If you want to clean your tools or anything that came in contact with brake fluid, you need to have denaturated alcohol for that. You can buy this in the port store. They have that kind of stuff. Denaturated alcohol is used to clean stuff that came in contact with brake fluid. Okay, so I remove my jack stands and I'm ready to go for a little road test. So we're going to try the brakes now. Going here decent speed down the road, and at the sign here we do on the full emergency brake. It's coming. There we go. So, brakes are working again.